Okay, guys, good evening to you all. Today I came up with this video because of the request from my students, Sinhala medium as well as English medium students, how to overcome the stress within the exam time period. Yeah, for the students who are facing for the O-level examination, they have now less than 3 months for the examination. So it is very important thing to understand how to manage your stress and how to make your mind for the examination. So because of my students' kind request, I thought to give my views how to overcome your stress within your exam time periods. Yeah, normally in my classes I always motivate my students how to overcome stress. I will give them advices, not only the lectures but also these advices also very important to your life, how to manage stress and take the good use of your time. Yeah, this will important for the students, not only for the all for the people who are doing all levels and people. It will be important to the students who facing for the examination, who are suffering from stress before the examination. Yeah, let's start our video in this way. Stress. When we consider that term, you should think with experience, I am telling, in each and every student of us, for all the people, for each and every one of us have that stress within us. Before going for examination, definitely we have a stress within us. It is a normal thing to almost all of us. First of all, you have to understand that. That is not a thing that you need to do. Most of the students think, I am stressed, I didn't work. But they are working, they are not stressed, they are doing well, but I am stressed and I am not doing anything. It's not doing anything at this time as well as wasting time for the future also. According to me, I think we have to divide our time. For the examination, I divide the time period into three clusters. Three time zones. It is what are the things students do before the examination, during the examination, as well as after the examination. These are the three clusters. These are the three time zones I divided from the students. To understand what to do in proper time is very important to face the examination well. You should understand those things. Some people say, what are the things that we want to do after the examination? Do we want to focus that? Definitely yes. After the examination also, you want to focus and you want to do it with the proper manner. Because you are not doing only one examination. You have to face for 8 more subjects. There are 9, all 9 subjects with you. So you have to focus almost all the subjects. So you have to focus what you are doing after the examination also. It is a very much important factor for a good all-round result from all the 9 subjects. So I will give different videos. I will upload some 2 more videos about what are the things you want to do during the examination and before the examinations. But from today video, I would like to give you a basic knowledge, basic advices how to overcome the stress and how you can get ready before the examinations, especially for the students who are doing O-level this time, because they have only few months, less than 3 months time period for their examination. Yeah, we can start like this. First, as I told you before, you should understand you are not the only one who suffering from pressure, suffering from stress. Each and every one of us suffering from stress or pressure before the exam. It is not unique to you, not only to you, but you should have some sort of stress within yourself. That little stress within your mind will motivate you to work hard for the examination. You should have some sort of stress, but don't let that little stress or the stress to overcome you. You should overcome the stress. So you should manage the stress well. Other than that, you should be a prisoner of your stress. and you are not going to do anything, just pressurize and just wasting your time. So first you have to overcome this too much of pressure in your mind. For that, I would invite you to work according to a timetable. Yeah. Timetable is a much important thing in our life. But for the students who are going to face the exam, I don't think you should need a proper timetable. It should be differ from day to day. But you should make a to-do list. With that to-do list, in each and every morning, when you get up, you should make a list. The things you have to list out the things. What are the things that you are going to do today? Do within today. And after you complete each and every task, you can put a star or put a mark for that. Then you can be happy about yourself. Sometimes you may work hard. You may work, do a lot of things, but you are not satisfying enough. But if you are able to list out them and list out with the priorities, from most important thing to least important thing, then after you take in a lot of ticks, or if you make them correct, if you go through with them, definitely you will be satisfied. You will be happy about yourself. So to release the stress within you, you should work according to a timetable, proper to-do list. Not only timetable, but I invite you to make a to-do list. It will differ from day to day. Today I have a different one, tomorrow I have another one, because tasks are different from day to day. Day to day you should have different to-do list, but you should prepare your to-do list within that time period, within that day, at the time you wake up. And put out to remove that overstress within you, you should overcome your mindset. Definitely that is one of the most important things. With the experience from the students, more than half of the students are just complaining on their past. They are thinking that I didn't do anything. I just waste my time early. And I'm not going to pass this exam. I will fail this because I waste the time early. So how can I overcome this? Yeah. This is a practical problem for more than half of the students with the experience I'm telling you. But Buddha, you have to understand this. In the past, in each and every one of us, it is a theory for me also. If I'm just sticking on my past and thinking about it, what is the benefit of it? From the past, we can learn different things. We can learn things to our life. But we can't change our past. It is already gone. So it is just wasting time. If we are just thinking about our past and just focusing on our past, we are just wasting our time. So try to learn something from past. The thing that you learned, you didn't learn. That's why you are stressed. If you are not going to start the work now onwards, definitely you will stress at the end of the exam. Because in the exam, there is no one for helping you. You have to face that. You have to overcome that challenge. Teachers or anyone else, your parents will help you before the exam. But in the exam, within that time period, you have to face it. So you have to overcome that. So don't be a present of your past. It is over. Yeah. If you work hard, it is okay. You are pretty sure that you work hard and you are happy about it. If you didn't work hard, it's also same. So no need to worry about it. You have to focus your mind from the present. If you work hard according to a timetable or manage your time well with a good mindset, definitely you can create a good future. That future, the tomorrow, the base of the future is the present time. So if you are able to work correctly in the present, if you are able to manage your time correctly in the present time, definitely you can build a good future. So don't, first to minimize the stress, to overcome this stress, first you want not to be a prisoner of your past. It's all. And move forward. Another important factor you should understand is you should live in the present. Don't think about your future also. Don't think about your past. You in the present, you should live in the present. Don't think anything too much. In this time period, you have to focus what you are doing. Don't think about future as well as past. that is one of the most important critical factor in our life. In human, we always try to think different things. Our mind is going here and there always. Because of that factors, because of that thing, we can't focus the single thing. We can't focus study. Okay, so don't think about anything at that time, in this time. Don't think about anything. Use this time to do the thing you are doing right now. If you are able to do correctly, you are able to manage your present. Definitely from this present, you can create a good future. That is one of the most important things.
As various assignments and test dates, it can quickly become overwhelming. By simply taking the time to get organized, such as putting class times in your calendar, including exam times and assignment due dates, you'll greatly reduce the sense of dread, chaos, and uncertainty you feel when approaching your academics. Organization extends to other aspects of your life too, like time management. Rather than approaching each day as a blank slate and then doing what you feel like when you feel like, try time blocking. During those hours when you know you'll be more focused and more productive, plan on setting aside a few hours for more intense and focused work or studying. During the hours when you know focusing will be difficult, block out time to get a workout in, or do laundry, or grab groceries. Staying organized in this way will also ward off procrastination, one of the most common and insidious stressors amongst students. And it mitigates the issues of balancing social stressors with academic stressors. If you know when to study and when to hang out with friends, you won't have to make the decision each time.
The bed.
You are getting stressed. I will recruit you. I will tell you few things to overcome that stress. We are stressing because we are not targeting us. Targeting a thing at a proper time. In my classes, I always tell my students, in this class, you should not think about anything. In that scenario, that is the main reason most of the students complain. Before 1 month or 2 months before the exam, they are telling we can't remember anything. What is the hell this is? We can't remember anything. We forgot everything. They are complaining us. The main reason for forgetting things, or main reason they can't remember things, the factor is they are not focusing what they are doing. They are thinking different things. Their mind is not focused to one thing. And without focusing, not only for you, but also for me, can't remember. It is a common thing to all of us. If you want to remember, if you want to keep something to your mind, if you want to keep something within your mind, you should be clean. You should be in clean mindset. You should be understand it with a clean mindset. So to do understand. If you are in a lecture, if you are asking to a video, if you are watching a video, you should properly understand what you are doing right now. Just be with yourself, be honestly, do the thing at that time. Don't think anything about that. So now you have 2 months time period. If you do things properly, definitely the things you are doing these days, remember until the exam. So do the things. If you are going to a lecture, if you are listening to a song, if you are making a short note, if you are doing a paper, you should just live in that paper within that time. If you are living in the paper in that time period, definitely you can give the best out from you. So to overcome this stress, and because of the I will give some suggestions for the people to maximize their memory. Yeah, for that I always recommend my students, You have number one point, you should focus what you are doing right now. Don't focus any other thing. Just like now, you just focus what you are doing right now. Then after, you should have a meditation. Some people say with religious things or any other things, they say, I can't do meditation. No. Meditation, some people define meditation in a wrong way. Meditation is keeping your mind for a certain time period focusing on one thing. Without focusing different things at once, for a little time period you have to focus on one thing. If you are able to focus your mind for one thing, that is the meditation. So I invite you all to, all my students, to do proper meditation from 15 minutes to 30 minutes each and every day. That will be a great saving for your future, and it will give a good mindset, will improve your brain and your brain thinking capacity, your logical thinking as well as memory, if you do like that. And Dua Puta, you should have a good sleep as well. We need a rest in our life. We can't work 24 hours. Just see the videos of people who take island brands. They always say they take proper sleep. You should take a proper sleep, 6 to 7 hours per day. With that time, you during the daytime you work, you study. In the resting time, in the time you sleep, the things you take to your mind will be correctly assembled. If you just take in the things to your mind and you are not doing the assembled thing correctly, if you are not keeping them in a proper way, it is just wasting time. So I invite you to do the meditation as well as have a proper sleep with you. Then you can easily improve your brain capacity and your memory power. So I think the way you should get ready for the exam is be different. Now from this video I tried to focus you on one thing, and I told you what are the factors, what are the things that you can do to overcome your stress. Because of the request, I would upload some more videos how you manage your time within the examination, how you face for the examination, oral examination as well as other examination, and how can you properly manage your time after the examination also. So I, with this video, I'm wishing my students good luck for your exams and do your best. This is the time that you can prove your parents that you are a person that handle the pressure, and you are a good person, you are a valuable person. Give that value to your life. From the value taken from your O levels, it will be the base for your A levels. That A level will be the base for your life. So put a good foundation for your life by taking a good results for your O level examination. So I invite you to go through these few factors. It will be important to you. Or give the comments if you like. Is it important to you or not? And if you have any suggestions to do, please request me. And if you have to add something more with your experience, I'm always like to take that advices and your comments also. So wishing you good luck. I hope to join in the next video. Thank you.